Hello and welcome to Influence Church.
We are so glad that you joined us today on online church from wherever you're watching.
Whatever time of day it is, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, we are so glad that you are here and that you've joined us for Influence Church online.
Amazing. I was just reading this morning a scripture in Psalm 121. And I think in this current day with all the stuff that's happening, it's a great way to start our service. It says this: I lift my eyes up to the mountains. Where does my help come from? And maybe right now in the situation you're in, you're wondering, where can I get help? We've got good news today. It says this: my help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he watches over Israel, will neither slumber or sleep. Do you know God's watching today, and we can lift our eyes up from situations, from the news, from the stuff that's happening, and focus on our God who is good and got great plans for you today.
That's right. So wherever you are and however you feel, we want to encourage you to engage in the service today. Get involved in the worship. Let's pray. Let's be expectant that God is going to speak to us through his word today. Welcome to church. Welcome to Influence Church online.
We're taking this praise to a whole new level. Walls are coming down. We're lifting your name to a whole new level. The breakthrough's all around. We're taking our faith to a whole new level. Storms are silenced now. We're lifting your name to a whole new level. We are ready now. We are ready now. You are for us, your power is in us, your love ignites us, fire consumes us. You are good, and all your ways are higher than my ways. Your name is great, and worthy to be praised. God, you're right. Your name endures when all else fades away. King of kings, we're here to bring you praise. We're taking this praise to a whole new level. Walls are coming down. We're lifting your name to a whole new level. Revival's coming now. Revival's coming now. You are for us. Your power is in us. Your love ignites us. Your fire consumes us. You are good. And all your ways are higher than my ways. Your name. God, you're right. Your name endures when all else fades away. King of kings, we're here to bring you praise. We won't be shaken. We won't stay silent, and we won't stop praising, and we'll never stop moving, and we won't be shaken, we won't stay silent, and we won't stop praising, and we'll never stop moving, and we won't be shaken, we won't stay silent, and we won't stop praising, 'cause you never stop moving. And we won't be shaken. And we won't stay silent. And we won't stop praising, 'cause you never stop moving. And you never stop moving. God, you never stop moving. Yeah. up through it. No matter what comes our way, you are moving. Hey, here we go. You are God. You are good, and all your ways are higher than my ways. Your name is great and worthy to be praised. God, you reign. Your name endures when all else fades away. King of kings, we're here to bring your praise. Your ways are higher than my ways. Your name is great and worthy to be praised. God, you reign. Your name endures when all else fades away. King of kings, we're here to bring you praise. King of kings, we're here to bring you praise. You're able to do it, I know you can. Cause God, you are faithful to move again. This mountain, it seems big, but I know you're with me. So Jesus, I'm grateful until the very end. I can hear your voice singing over me. I'm free indeed. I can feel your power washing over me. And I'm free indeed. You are my Savior, so I won't fear. Cause I know you've got this, your power is here. Oh, you are my breakthrough, you're making all things new. So I praise you forever, to you I say. I can hear your voice singing over me. And I'm free indeed. I can feel your power washing over me. And I'm free indeed. Hey. I can hear your voice singing over me. And I'm free indeed. I can feel your power washing over me, and I'm free indeed. And God is on the throne, He is in control, reigning over all. He is powerful, so powerful. I lift his name and I give him praise. He will make a way. He is powerful, so powerful. can hear your voice singing over me, and I'm free indeed. Yeah, I can feel your power washing over me, and I'm free indeed. And God, you're on the throne. You are in control, reigning over all. You are powerful, so powerful. Lift your name, and I give you praise, for you will make a way. You are powerful, so powerful. You are powerful, so powerful. You are powerful. You are mighty. You are my Savior, and I put all my trust in you. I put all my hope in you, 'cause I know that you never fail. Your love remains. Your name is everlasting. Your name is higher than any other name. More powerful than any other name. I put my trust in you. Put my hope in you. And everything I am, I lay before you. I bring it before you now. All my doubt, all my fear, all my shame, I lay it before you. There's nothing is too hard for you. There's no distance that I could run where your love can't reach me. There's no height that I could climb that goes beyond your reach. Jesus, it says in Zephaniah chapter 3, for the Lord your God is living among you. He is a mighty Savior. He will take delight in you with gladness. And with his love, he will calm all your fears. He will rejoice over you with joyful songs. You know, the amazing thing is that no matter how many songs of worship we bring before our Savior Jesus, you know, we could never actually outdo the songs of joy that he is singing over us. no matter what circumstances we face, no matter what stands before us, nothing is too hard, no obstacle is too great for the power of our Savior. He is mighty to save. I've seen you move the mountains, and I believe I'll see you do it again. You made a way where there was no way, and I believe I'll see you do it again. Still stand. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. Faithfulness, I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail. You never fail me.
You know, at this time, and every time really, prayer is so key. And perhaps right now, with everything that's happening, even more so, do we need to press into the presence of God. There's loads of stuff happening. It's changing day to day, hour to hour. But God is our consistent in this time. It may feel like a storm is raging, but we know that God consistently calms storms with his words. And one of the great things that God says is in Philippians 4, from chapter 6, it says this: do not be anxious about anything. That seems like an easy idea, but how do we not be anxious? Well, it says this: in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. That's what prayer does. And remembering to thank him, it guards our hearts. And right now, we need to be really wise and protect our minds and hearts from all the stuff that's happening. Make sure that we stay calm and not worrying about stuff, because we know that God is in control. So I'd encourage you to spend time this week, today, pressing into God, remembering to thank him, because he's a good God and he's able to do so much, and he can give you peace. It doesn't feel like it's a natural situation where we can have peace, but that's the crazy good thing about God. He's not natural, he's supernatural. So he can fill your mind with peace right now. We're going to pray before we move on with our service. God, we thank you that you are the calm in our storm. God, you are the anchor. And although we feel like there's a storm raging around us and there's uncertainty everywhere, God, we thank you that you are the solid rock on which we can build our life. God, we pray right now for peace that passes understanding for every person, every man, every woman, every boy, every girl, every leader, every person that's following God, whether they know you or not. God, we pray for peace that passes understanding. God, we pray for wisdom for our leaders in our nation as well as they try to lead us through this time. God, we thank you that you are in control. In your name, Jesus. Amen.
So, lots is changing in this time, but lots is still happening. So we want to take a moment for you to find out just some of the things that are going on within Influence Church in this time, in this season, that you can get involved with. So this is Church News. Just when you thought you'd seen it all, we've got another new feature coming your way for this season. So much stuff happening in the life of church, and we just want to help you walk through this season with great faith and with God in your side. And so we've got a new feature coming to you very soon called COVID Conversations. And myself and Gail are going to be talking to some great friends, some guests from around the country and international guests from around the world, looking at different topics of how we can strengthen our walk with God in this season. We're going to be looking at things like marriage, we're going to be looking at mental health and many other things, talking with guests who can help to equip you with what God wants to do to strengthen you in this season. We don't just want to survive, we want to thrive through this.
In this time, it is so key that we are growing ourselves spiritually. A great resource that will help you with this are our daily devotions, which are available via our Influence app and also on our website at influencechurch.co.uk/devotions. These will give you a great starter into your daily devotion with God, but I just want to encourage you, don't just stay with the devotion, but why not use that as a springboard into your own daily devotion and get into the Word of God yourself. Begin to take your own thoughts on the certain passage that's been touched on in the daily devotion, and that will grow you, that will strengthen you, and that will feed your faith.
There is loads going on for our young people and children at this time, so make sure that you get yourself connected. If you're Elevate age, which is 11 to 17, then make sure that you follow their Instagram page, We Are Elevate One. On there, they're having weekly devotionals, they're having weekly preaches. There's also the opportunity to join connect groups. If you're part of Hero Factory, which caters for ages 3 up to 11, then again, there is loads happening. Make sure you connect on the Facebook page, search for Hero Factory. On there, you'll find videos with challenges, there's preachers, there's also worksheets that you can print off and fill out at home. There's also weekly challenges that are happening for the kids to build up points throughout this time of lockdown. So make sure you get yourself connected with Elevate or Hero Factory today.
Church News today. We hope you feel re-informed and ready for the week ahead. To make sure that you stay connected, make sure that you are part of a virtual connect group. They're meeting in homes all across our towns, and there's a place for you to belong. Maybe you're new to church or you're just trying us out, but you want to be more connected. These groups meet in all different ways, and there's a place for you. Make sure you're signed up to the emails, you're part of the Facebook and Instagram groups, and make sure that you stay fully connected in this time. We're socially distant, but we want to be relationally very connected. See you soon.
During this time of staying at home, it's important that we still connect with one another, show love and kindness to each other, and share with those in need. The weekend before we were asked to stay at home, me and my children decided that we wanted to go out and be a blessing to our neighborhood. So we had a fun leaving gifts on the doorsteps of people in our neighborhood. And it reminded me that actually when we show kindness, when we do good to other people, when we bless those in need, that it not only blesses other people, but it also is enjoyment for us. I want to read to you Hebrews 13:16 that says this: Do not forget to do good and to share with others, for with such sacrifices, God is pleased. You see, when we do good, when we share with those in need, like I said before, not only do we enjoy it, but God is pleased. And at this time, it can be so easy to become self-focused. As we're isolating ourselves, it can become easy to be able to just focus on ourselves and our needs. But let me encourage you to be pleasing to God at this time and to be a blessing to other people. Let's do all that we can to share with those in need and to show kindness and to love to our community. You could do good by maybe sending a letter, sending a card of some encouragement. Maybe you could phone someone. Maybe you could invite people to watch church with you. You know, it's going to be good for you and it's going to be good for others. Maybe you could do good by praying for other people. Or maybe you could do good by giving in some way. You could give food to our food bank, or you could give into the life of Influence Church. You see, we may not be meeting physically in the building at the moment, but our church is still very much at work. We're providing youth and children activities online. We've got our virtual connect groups, and our food banks are still open. We are still feeding those people in need. So let's do all that we can to be people who do good and who share with others. And if you want to give into the life of Influence Church today, you can take a moment right now to go to influencechurch.co.uk/giving and give online today.
Surrounding me, let it break at your name. Still, call the sea to still, and the rage you need to still every wave at your name, Jesus, Jesus. And you make the darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus. You silence fear, and Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus. Breathe, call these bones to live, and call these lungs to sing once again, and I will pray. Jesus, Jesus, and you make the darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus, and you silence fear, and Jesus, Jesus, and you make the darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus.
Can not be overcome.
We want to welcome you once again to Influence Church Online. Whether you are part of our church in any of our physical locations, Richmond, Barnard Castle, Penrith, Bishop Auckland, right across the north of England, or whether you were just scrolling through Facebook and you happen to find us today, we are so glad that you are here. We want to welcome you to church. And we believe that today God wants to speak to you. Now, for some of you, that might seem like a crazy idea that God would want to speak to you. But we truly believe that God is great and almighty, yet he's close and personal. He's the God who created the entire world, and yet he's interested in you and me, and that he wants to speak to us. And so today, you don't have to worry about whether you are good enough or whether you are godly enough, but just whether you are open enough to believe that God would want to speak to you today. So before we get into things, why don't we pray right now? God, we just thank you for the opportunity to gather today here for church online. We thank you that your word tells us, God, that when we draw near to you, that you promise to draw near to us. And so we might be at home watching through screens right now, but thank you that we can still have an encounter with you and we can still hear from you. Help us to drown out and tune out to the different distractions that are going on in our day-to-day lives. And right now, just for a moment, tune in to hear with what you would want to say to us. In the name of Jesus, we ask, amen. Just 2 weeks ago, we had our Easter Sunday services, our Easter online experiences. And because of what's going on in the world at the moment, I don't know whether 2 weeks for you seems like just yesterday or whether it feels like 2 years ago. But it was actually only 2 weeks ago that we had our Easter Sunday experiences. And that was an amazing day. And we loved having thousands of people join us from not just across our locations and our country, but people tuning in from right across the world to hear a message of hope on Easter Sunday. And our theme for Easter was hope in the dark. And that's not only a great message for Easter Sunday, but actually I think it's a great message. It's a great theme for us, for all of us in this season that we're facing. That all of us need to understand that there is hope in the midst of uncertainty, that there can be light in the midst of darkness, that there can be courage in the midst of chaos. We all need hope in the dark. And the Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 6 and verse 19, it says, we have this hope. That's our hope. That's our trust. That's our relationship with God. We have this hope as an anchor for our souls. It is firm, it is secure. We have this hope as an anchor for our souls, firm and secure. You know, there are many things in your world, many things in my world that have changed a lot in the last 6 weeks. Things that used to be secure, things that used to be stable have now changed and become uncertain. But the Bible tells us that our hope in God is like an anchor. It's certain, it's unchanging, it's stable, it is firm and secure. That in a time when many other things have become uncertain, God is always faithful. That we can always put our trust in him, that we can always put our hope in him. And I want to take a couple of minutes to talk to you today on the idea of endurance in our faith. What it means not to just have our trust and have our faith in God, but to endure in our faith with God. A few weeks ago, I went on a walk with my boys. For those of you who don't know me, I got two sons, Asher and Noah, who are 15 and 12. And we've been taking the opportunity in our government-mandated exercise times to not just go out on exercise, but actually to go out on exploration. And so we've taken the challenge on a number of occasions over the last few weeks to head out on an adventure of exploration from our front door to see what we can find in the beautiful town of Richmond that we live in. Places that possibly we drive past all of the time, but we've never taken the opportunity to explore fully. Or paths and alleyways and hills and forests that we've been to occasionally in previous years, but not actually taken the time to explore properly. And so we've been turning our exercise into exploration, turning the opportunity to explore different things as boys together. Of course, as boys going on walks, we're walking with sticks because sticks is the right thing to do when you go for a manly walk. And a couple of weeks ago, maybe 2-3 weeks ago, we went on an adventure, and we were going through a forest and down a hill, and it's a beautiful part of town. For those of you who are local to Richmond, it's the forest just off Maison Dieu on the way down to Easby, and it's a stunning place. There's great views across our town where you can see the castle and you can see the river. And the day we were exploring on was a beautiful day. The sun was shining through the trees, and we were just taking time to have some fun together on our daily exercise. And so we're walking through this forest. We're walking down hills and up hills. We're climbing up trees. We're hiding places to hide. We're scrambling up different things and over things and just generally doing things that boys do, making our way up and down through this beautiful area and having such fun doing this. But at one point came to a crossroads moment, if you like, where we got stuck. We'd come down the hill, this pretty steep hill, and it was a dry day, the sun was shining, but halfway down this hill, one of the beautiful parts about it is there's a freshwater spring that comes out halfway through the hill, which is really nice in some ways, but really muddy in other ways. And suddenly we realized we'd got to this point where we were stuck. To go forward, the path was blocked, there was fallen trees and there was mud everywhere. To go back wasn't impossible, but it was a steeper and bigger hill than we were fancying to climb at the time. And so we realized that we'd got stuck at this point, and this is where endurance kicks in. Endurance is the ability to keep going even when things are hard. Endurance is the ability to not be beaten by a situation, but to rise above it. And so we stopped for a couple of moments and we assessed what was going on, and eventually we kept going and we found a way. Now, I'm not trying to make this moment out to be like some biblical representation. This wasn't the Red Sea. This wasn't the Jordan River. There wasn't an army coming against us. There wasn't a flood. There wasn't certain death on one side and only one way forward. This wasn't really a life-changing, disastrous situation. More a situation of perhaps mild inconvenience. But eventually we managed to endure through that season to find a way to be able to keep going, and we overcame. And I want us to stick on this idea of endurance today. What does it mean for us to endure in our faith? That when things get tough, that we don't give up. That when things seem difficult, we actually realize that they might be difficult, but they're not impossible. That when we come up against obstacles, we have a God who makes a way where there seems to be no way. The Bible tells us in Romans chapter 8, verse 31 tells us, if God is for us, who can be against us? That same passage of scripture goes on in Romans 8 and verse 37 to tell us that we are more than conquerors through Christ who loved us. That we can be overcomers, that we can be conquerors, not just conquerors, but more than conquerors. Not because we were burly and brave and courageous enough, but actually our ability to overcome, our ability to be more than a conqueror comes through Christ who loved us. That it's something about our relationship with God. It's something about the faith that we place in God that gives us the ability to rise up and above and be bold and brave and courageous through Christ who loved us. For those of you who've been with us on this journey of Church Online over the last couple of weeks, you'll know that one of the new features we're doing is our after church hangout. Every Sunday evening, 6:15, we've been taking to Instagram Live to have a little bit of fun together as a church community, talking about some serious things and some stupid things along the way. And again, a few weeks ago on Easter Sunday, we were joined by a very special guest, Pastor Mark Ritchie. Mark is a great man of God, communicates the gospel across the world, and he joined us on Instagram to mostly talk gibberish about what it would look like to post curry through a letterbox and other stupid ideas. But in the midst of all the random things we were talking about, we asked Mark something about his thoughts for us as a church in this season, and he said something that I'd already been thinking at the time. He said, we might be locked down, but we can still rise up. That we might be facing a situation that none of us have faced before, a time of social distancing and isolation and all of the limitations that we're facing at the moment. But he was saying there's still the opportunity for Christians, there's still the opportunity for the church, to our faith to rise up in this season. And I love that challenge. I love that idea that we might be facing obstacles, but God still has opportunity in the midst of that. At the moment, all of our plans might have been canceled, but God's purposes are still advancing. And just in case you've lost all track and sense of time and date and location and everything else in your life, this weekend would have been our Rise Conference weekend, a time when we gather together as the whole church, all our locations of influence church come together, as well as guests and friends from right around the country and guests actually from international countries as well, coming together for the purpose of strengthening and equipping the church to be somebody who rises up. Now, our conference might have been cancelled in this season, but the purpose of that conference still continues. The purpose of that conference still endures, to empower us to rise up in our faith, to equip us to be God's light in our world, to be strengthened and encouraged in our faith, that what God has done in the past isn't the limitation of what God can do, that there's so much more that He wants to do, that when we step into His purposes and we rise up, God can use us to be part of His plan and purpose. And we might not be gathered for a conference, but that message is still so true for us today. That we might be locked down, but we can still rise up in our faith. And I want us to look at a passage of scripture today that I think helps to equip us in strengthening our faith so that we can endure through this season and actually come out stronger on the other side. The passage is in Hebrews chapter 12, and we've already read a couple of passages today from the book of Hebrews, a fantastic book written to strengthen and equip the local church, written 2,000 years ago, and still has something powerful and relevant to say into our lives today. And Hebrews chapter 12 from verse 1 says this: "Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with endurance the race marked out before us. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such opposition from sinful men, so that you will not grow weary and you will not lose heart." Right now, we're living through something that has never happened before. We're facing challenges individually, as a nation, and as a world that we've never had previous experience of. And so I would encourage you, now is not the time to grow weary. Now is not the time to lose heart. Now is not the time to give up. But now is the time to rise up. Now is the time to endure in our faith. Now is the time for us to run the race of faith, like the writer of Hebrews says, run the race of faith with endurance. Now is the time for us to rise up and to endure in our faith. And as the writer goes on, he gives us this incredible passage that paints the picture of our relationship with God, having faith in God, being like a journey and being like a race. Paints this picture for us of a race. You're all familiar with racing in different ways, a physical race. And it says actually our walk with God, our relationship with God in this instance is painted for us in this picture like a race. And it gives us two keys to endurance, two keys that I want us just to pick up on just for a couple of minutes today that will help us today, I think, endure in our faith and overcome in our faith and rise up in our faith in the midst of this season. The two keys are to throw off and to fix on. Throw off, fix on. Number one, verse one, sorry, it says, "Let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with endurance the race marked out before us." Now, this might come as a surprise to some of you, but I've never been particularly sporty. Never been one for throwing myself into athletic activities or endurance things or whatever. And so when I was at school, imagine back to your school days. For some of you, that's not that long ago. For some of you, it's a very long time ago. Imagine yourself back in your school days when sports day rolled around. Sports day was never my favorite day in the academic calendar. I enjoyed the opportunity to get out of lessons for a whole day. Didn't necessarily enjoy the opportunity to be able to compete in sporting endeavors in front of a large crowd of people. And so when sports day rolled around, there were some challenges for me. But one thing I excelled in when it came to sports day was always the obstacle race. So think back a little bit further into your primary school days. I believe that obstacle races are mainly on your primary school days. You don't see many teenagers being thrown into the obstacle race, as far as I know. But back in my primary school days, I was the winner, the gold medal winner of the obstacle race on more than one occasion. That was the peak of my sporting achievements for my lifetime up to this point, I believe, was the obstacle race winner for a couple of years back in the early 90s. I loved the obstacle race. The idea of starting at one place and there was a finish line, but along the way, there were different things that you had to overcome. There were hoops that you had to climb through. There were nets that you had to crawl under. There were hurdles that you had to jump. There were sometimes costumes that you had to pull on and run for a few meters before you took it off and then crawled under the net or whatever it might be. And the idea of the obstacle race is not just that you're competing, but you're overcoming along the way, overcoming these various obstacles that stand in your way. And this passage of scripture that we read here in Hebrews paints this idea of a race, but it tells us that there are some things along the way that could slow us down. There are some things along the way that could become obstacles, that could become hindrances to your race. And it tells us in this passage in verse 1 to throw off everything that hinders. Throw off all the things that could slow you down, that could get in your way from running the race of faith with endurance. It says there are a couple of things to throw off. The first is the sin that so easily entangles. Sin is the things that are offensive to God. It says throw off what's offensive to God, but also you got to throw off the things that are an obstacle to you and me. Notice though, in this passage, when we're reading it, it tells us to throw off everything that hinders. It doesn't then give us a list of what hinders us. It'd be helpful perhaps if it could just spell out for us the ABC, the 1, 2, 3. If you leave this behind, if you don't do this thing, if you don't watch this program, if you don't spend time with this person, if you don't make this choice or that choice, then you're going to be absolutely fine. But it doesn't give us a list, because actually what hinders you is unique to your walk with God. The things that could be an obstacle for you might not be an obstacle for somebody else. The things that might be a big problem in my life might be really easy for you. And so what hinders you is unique to you. And that's why we have to sometimes take a moment and say, what is it that's slowing me down in this season? What is it that's limiting my faith in this moment? What is it that's a hindrance to my faith journey in this time? Perhaps for you, it's an old way of thinking. Perhaps it's a certain habit or addiction. Perhaps it's a wrong relationship. Maybe it's a wrong priority in family or in finance. I don't know what it looks like for you, but I know that all of us have things that cause hindrances in our faith. Things that we allow to stick in our lives that are actually slowing us down from running forward in our race with God. The Bible tells us to throw off everything that hinders. And then it says the second thing was to throw off and to fix on. Verse 2 says this: let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. Fix our eyes on Jesus. You know, this passage was written to us over 2,000 years ago. And so we're reading direct from scripture written thousands of years ago. But I love how scripture always has the power to speak perfectly into our lives in any season and in any situation. That this passage wasn't written to a church who are facing a global pandemic. And yet there is truth and there is power in these words that can be transformational for our individual lives today. It might not have been written to a season where they were facing a pandemic, but this scripture is written to help strengthen believers in the face of any fear in any generation. To throw off everything that hinders, and then it gives us this advice to fix our eyes on Jesus. That whatever situation you're facing, whatever it is that you are struggling with in this season, and that struggle might be unique to you, because everyone's dealing with this circumstance in different ways and facing different trials. Some of you, it's to do with finance, some to do with family, some it's to do with health, some to do with mental health, some to do with panic and fear. We're all dealing with it in a different way. But whatever it is that you're facing, whenever it is that you come up against something that you don't know how to get past, whenever you're feeling overwhelmed, whenever you're facing the obstacles, it tells us the ability to endure in our faith is found through throwing off the things that hinder and then fixing our eyes on Jesus. Taking time to make a priority of the presence of God. Taking time to close sometimes our physical eyes to everything else that's going on around us and allowing our time spiritually to fix our eyes on the author and the perfecter of our faith. The one who is walking with us through every test and trial. The one who is with us through every season and circumstance and situation. Think about when you're running a race and when you have to fix your eyes. Think about when you're driving a car and you have to fix your eyes. When you're moving forward with something, the ability to understand the right focus is so important for you. And the same is so true in our spiritual lives, in how we're going to endure in our faith through this season. Stop allowing your time and your focus to be on people or on the problems that are around you. Stop thinking about what's ahead of you or what's behind of you. Stop focusing on the obstacles that are possibly around your feet at the moment and start lifting your eyes to fix your eyes on Jesus. The one who is with you right now, however it is that you feel, whatever it is that you are going through, right now he is there with you. Allow your eyes to be taken off all of the other things around and fix your eyes on Jesus. Bible says in Psalm 121 verse 1, it says, I lift my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Where does my help come from? It comes from God. But the first part of the verse tells us to lift our eyes. A more accurate translation of this scripture is actually not to lift our eyes to the hills, but when you understand the language in which it was written here in the Greek, is to lift our eyes above the hills. It's a declaration of faith in this time that actually the source that I'm looking to for the strength that I need, the source that I'm looking to for the peace that I need, for the joy that I need, for the guidance and the wisdom and the revelation, whatever I need, the source that I'm looking to is not anything of human effort or even earthly provision. I'm not looking to the hills, I'm looking above the hills. Because what I need doesn't come from a natural source, it can only come from a supernatural source. So lift your eyes above the hills and fix your eyes on the one who can provide for you in this season. Fix your eyes above the problem and start facing them on the provider, the one who walks with us through every season, the one who promised to be with us and never leave us nor forsake us, the one who promised us that when our trust is in him, we will not be shaken. Lift your eyes above the hills, it says. And I want to encourage you today in whatever it is that you're facing, lift your eyes up. Lift your eyes up above the problems of today. Lift your eyes up above the panic and the fear. Lift your eyes up above the uncertainty of what's happening in your workplace. Lift your eyes up above all of the what-if questions that all of us have in this season. Lift your eyes up above the things of our natural world and fix your eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. Stop focusing on the things that have gone wrong. Stop focusing on the problems and start looking to the provider, because he's the supernatural source for us in this season. Let us run with endurance the race marked out before us. And I don't know about you, but for me in this season, faith has been my greatest strength through everything I'm facing right now. It's faith that has given me peace. It's faith that has given me strength. It's faith that has given me courage when things were uncertain and I couldn't see a way forward. It's my faith that has carried me through this season. And we need to learn to endure in our faith, to throw off the things that hinder, to get rid of the things that are going to slow us down and distract us, and fix our eyes on Jesus. And I want us to take a moment to do that right now. I wonder if you could close your physical eyes right now. Because actually, for us to fix our eyes on Jesus, we have to close our eyes to the earthly things that are going on right now. I don't know where it is you're watching. Maybe you just sat on your sofa watching your TV. You sat in bed or on your phone. But right now, let's just take a moment to shut out all of the distractions in our earthly world that we're living in. Try to close your eyes so that we limit the things that are going on around us and we can take a moment to focus on what God wants to say to us. That passage says, I lift my eyes above the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. And God, right now, we just take a moment to fix our eyes upon you. to remove and throw off all of the things that hinder us, that slow us down, that distract us from moving forward in our relationship with you. You know, right now, that God wants to be your source of everything in this time. He wants to be your source of help. Where does my help come from, it says. He wants to be your source of help. He wants to be your source of strength. He wants to be your source of joy. He wants to be your source of hope and peace in this season. And so right now, as we've just taken a moment to close our eyes off to all the other distractions, maybe there's some of you this morning, this afternoon, this evening, whatever time it is that you're watching, maybe there's some of you that as you're watching right now, you need to put your hope and put your trust in God. To be able to take a moment to say, there's been too many things that have been slowing me down, too many things I've been focused on, all this other stuff going on, but right now I want to make a choice to fix my eyes upon Jesus. And you can do that. Wherever it is you're watching, whatever it is you're going through, you can always choose, Jesus, I want to say yes to you. I want to say yes to a relationship with you. There's a website that we've created that we want to connect you with that I think will just help you in this season. If you want to take a moment today to say yes to Jesus, there's a website. You can go to influencechurch.co.uk/yes. You can even write yes in the comments right now. We've got people online who just want to be able to connect with you. And if you know that in this season you've been looking to all sorts of other things and you haven't been finding the peace and the joy and the strength that you need, I want to tell you it can only be found in a relationship with God. And God offers that relationship to every one of us. All he asks us to do is say yes. And so you can visit the website, you can say yes in the comments, and you can start the most incredible relationship with God right now. And for all of us, whether you have faith or not, I want to encourage you that to endure in your faith is the thing that's going to strengthen you in this time. Throw off everything that hinders, fix your eyes on Jesus. God, we thank you for the opportunity to connect with you. We thank you that that faith in you gives us a firm foundation, that when everything else seems uncertain, we can put our trust in you and we can know that you are with us, that you never leave us, and that you are carrying us through this season. Give us that courage and that boldness to put our trust in you, to say yes to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you so much for joining us today at Church Online. Listen, we'd love to connect with you more, so make sure that you visit our website, influencechurch.co.uk, to find out anything else that's happening. Stay connected with our Facebook and Instagram to see all the updates. And make sure, if you want to be more part of things, that you are part of a virtual connect group so we can make sure that we are serving you, equipping you, and getting you really plugged in this time. Have a great week, whatever's happening, and we'll see you soon. Thank you.